Happy Sunday, y'all. But it's not just any Sunday.
But it's you Sunday.
Hey, y'all, it's you Sunday.
Hey, buddy, it's you Sunday.
Hey, everyone, it's you Sunday.
It's our Sunday. Yay!
Hey, it's you Sunday.
Peace.
What is you Sunday?
Hey, everybody, it's you Sunday.
Hey, everybody, it's you Sunday, you know.
Yes, it's our Sunday. Yay!
Hey, people, it's me, Christian. Go down to Sunday because it's our Sunday. It's God's Sunday, most importantly. And this is what we need to do. See you at church. Au revoir.
That's right. It is our Sunday as the Future Church Holiness 2.0.
Nobody stopping my shine. They try to break me, try to take me out, but I got Jesus on my side. So bad I thought I would die, but ain't no power stronger than the one that came and laid down his life. And I got mountains to climb, but the enemy can't stop me, cause there's a calling on my life. So when I'm crying, don't last too long, cause he gon' step in and make it alright.
Praise, because he is so worthy. He's been so good to us and so kind to us. Welcome into the sanctuary. We want to invite you to join with us in a high praise and praise and worship, and we are ready to celebrate the Lord and our King and our God on this morning. Can you open up your mouth and give God some praise? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord on this morning. Open up your mouth and give the praise. He's worthy. Yes, he is. Come on, put your hands together and help us sing this on this morning. Lord of all, Lord of the world, you are God of all the earth. And sing of your marvelous work. Every knee shall bow before, and every tongue confess that you are Lord.
No! say we worship you.
We worship you.
All glory's yours.
All glory's yours.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord.
The Lord of all.
The Lord of all.
We worship you.
We worship you.
All glory's yours.
All glory's yours.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord.
The Lord of all.
The Lord of all.
We worship you.
We worship you.
All glory's yours.
All glory's yours.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord.
The Lord of all.
The Lord of all.
We worship you.
We worship you.
All glory's yours.
All glory's yours.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord.
The Lord of all.
The Lord of all.
We worship you.
We worship you.
All glory's yours.
All glory's yours.
You are the Lord.
You are the Lord.
The Lord of all.
The Lord of all.
All glory's yours.
You are the Lord.
The Lord of all.
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 The Lord of my life.
The Lord of all.
The Lord of all.
The Lord of all.
The Lord of my heart.
The Lord of all.
The Lord of all.
The Lord of all.
Everlasting God. Hallelujah. You're so worthy, God. So worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, the song goes like this. The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? Whom shall I be afraid? I will wait on you. I will wait on you. You. I will trust in you. Yes, I will. I will trust in you. Help me sing, y'all.
The Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear?
Oh.
Whom shall I be afraid?
The Lord is my light.
The Lord is my light and salvation.
Whom shall
I fear?
No one.
Whom shall I be afraid?
I will wait on you. Yes, I will. I'll wait.
I will wait on you.
Trust in you. It goes like this. I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord. Help me say, I will.
I will remain confident in this.
I will see the goodness of the Lord. The Lord,
the Lord is my
light and salvation.
Who shall I be afraid?
Oh God,
the Lord is my and sound.
Who shall I be afraid? I will wait on you. Yes, I will. Yes, I will.
I will wait on you.
I will trust in you.
Trust in you. this I will see the goodness of the Lord.
Can y'all help us sing? I will remain.
I will remain. Oh. Confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
Oh God, we open up our hearts to you, God. We give our souls to you, Jesus. We just want you to rain down your blessings in this atmosphere. You know why?
Because we set our hope on you. We set our hope on your love. We set our hope on the one who is the everlasting God. You are the everlasting God.
Can y'all help us sing that this morning?
We set our hope. Goodness of the Lord.
If you know you're gonna see it, let me hear you sing it.
I will remain,
yeah,
confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
I wanna hear y'all sing, y'all sing, y'all sing.
I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
I will wait on you. I'm not going to rush it. I'm going to be patient and wait on you, Lord, because I know you have something for me.
I will wait on you. And I will trust in you. I will trust in you. So I will remain confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
I will remain
confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
I'm already seeing it, but I know he has more for me. I will remain
confident in this. I will see the goodness of the Lord.
Serve the everlasting God. And God, I love you. I love you more than anything. Anybody. You are first in my life. You are the head of my life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I lift my hands. Total adoration unto you.
I lift my hands in total adoration unto you. You reign on the throne, for you are God
and God alone. Because of you, my cloudy days are gone. I can sing to you this song. I just want to say that I love you more than anything.
Y'all can help us sing it this time.
I lift my hands in total adoration to you.
Lord, you reign.
You reign upon the throne. For you are God and God alone.
Because of you, my cloudy
days are gone.
I can sing to you.
I can sing to you. This song.
I just want to say that I love you more than anything. Oh, love me in your arms. You are my shelter.
You are my shelter from the storm.
When all my friends, when they're gone, you are right there. I've never known a love like this
I love you more than anything. I love you, Jesus. I worship and adore you. I just want to tell you, Lord, I love you more than anything.
If you love him in this room and online today, help us sing it.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore you.
I worship and adore you.
I just want to tell
Lord, I love you.
Lord, I love you more than anything. Can we raise it up right here? I love you, Jesus.
I love you, Jesus.
I worship and adore your name.
I
just want to tell you, Lord, I love you.
I just wanna tell you,
Lord, I love you. special way. That's why I praise you.
Yes, I do, Lord.
I lift you up and I magnify your name. That's why my heart is filled with praise. Oh, that's why my heart is filled with praise. That's why. Lord, you're worthy. I adore you. I lift up your name. I magnify your name. I bless your name. Glory to the name, Jesus. Glory to your name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory. You're worthy. You're worthy. We love you. We love you. We love you, we love. Lord, I love you more than
again, happy youth. Look at the youth over here, y'all. Shout out to the youth. I'm trying to shake things up a little bit where on youth Sundays, they have their own designated area to where it's just them. That way we can focus on them and see, oh, okay, this is our future right here. So I need to be interceding for them. Amen? Amen? Praise God. For those who may not know who I am Minister Malik John. And I'm over our youth department here at Breath of Life Christian Center. And I'm very excited to be here with you all again. But before I really get into it, I do want to, first of all, just want to give a shout out to my beautiful wife, girl. It's my first time doing this with my wife, so you know what I'm talking about, girl. What's up? Woo! I ain't gonna say nothing else, cause she gonna get mad at me. And I don't wanna make her mad. But man, I'm just happy to be here. Yasmin, I love you. I thank God for you. You know, it's been a happy 2 months so far, and you know. But I will say this: stop asking us when we having children. That's our business, not yours. All right, praise God. Hopefully that ends the conversation. All right. We will let you know when we's ready. Amen. Praise God. Let me also just give a huge shout out to the Highway Response Team. Highway 10, can y'all just raise your hand, wave your hand or something? I see Steven. I see a few others. I just want to thank God. I just want to thank you all so, so much. We came back in person starting in August of last year. And we haven't been able to get every team member back. But the team members we've had, let me tell you, their diligence, their faithfulness towards your children, your well-behaved angels, is unprecedented. And whatever you think Minister Malik is, I'm nothing without the team. So I want to make sure that they know that I appreciate them so, so very much. And the team is growing, so you know I'll still be recruiting. And then, of course, let me give a shout out to 181. We start our Zoom services this Wednesday for our high schoolers. Ooh, I'm excited. So, you know, if you have high school age children, make sure they are with us on Wednesday nights, 7:30 p.m. More information on the website. You so fine, girl. But I'm gonna get to preaching. Praise. Y'all ready to get into the word? Y'all ready to get into the word? Praise God. Let's pray and let's get on our way. Father God, first of all, we just thank you and we praise you, Lord, for this day. We thank you and we praise you, Father God, for just allowing us to see this day, this extraordinary day of which we have never seen before, Father. Lord, we thank you and we praise you for this ministry that we are back and stronger than ever in the name of Jesus. Father God, I thank you and we praise you, Lord, for your word. For your word is true because your word is you, Lord. So, Father God, we look to see what you have in store for all of us on today, Father God. I pray, Father God, right now that our hearts and minds are ready to receive you. And in that, Father God, use me as you see fit. Holy Spirit, I am your vessel. I decrease, you increase in me. Have your way through me, Holy Spirit, to give revelation, knowledge, and illumination to your people on today, Father. Father God, we truly love you and we thank you. And it is in your holy Son Jesus' name that we pray. Amen. 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 So, I want to start off with, a premise, if you will. Breath of Life, do me a favor. Just look around you right quick. Just look around. Just look around. Look up, down, look in the back, look in the front. Look all around. These seats will be filled. Not only will they be filled, they will be filled soon. And not only will they be filled soon, they'll be filled with the youth. They'll be filled with the hood, with the streets, with our people, and even other ethnic groups. They're going to be filled very soon, sooner than you think. But in that, I ask you, are you ready to receive them? Are you ready to receive who's coming? See, as we now move forward in the next 40 years of this ministry, how holiness looks doesn't look different, but how we give it to them does. As we move forward in the next 40 years, known as Holiness 2.0, it is imperative that we don't change the message of holiness, just how we express holiness. Amen? See, Tua, I know it's been kind of a little whisper in the street, so I'm going to hush it right now. The message of holiness ain't changed. The standard ain't changed. But how we express it must change. Amen? So today we're going to get into holiness communicated. Everyone say holiness communicated. Holiness communicated. Because let me give y'all an idea of who's going to be here, who's coming soon here. There are going to be some young people that's going to come. It's going to be a young man, a young king who don't know it yet. He's going to come through these doors, high heels on in a dress. Are you ready to receive him? It's going to be a young queen who don't know it yet. She's going to come through these doors. Her pants going to be baggier than mine. Will you be ready to receive her? It's going to be some people that's going to come up in this thing, having done smoking weed in the car, pull up in here with the intentions to smoke it when they leave here. Are you ready to receive them? And even the young people we have, we're all learning and training. Are you ready to receive them? And again, we're not changing the message of holiness, just how we express it. Amen. And so in there, let me give y'all some synonyms. I'm not sure they'll be on the screen or not, but some synonyms for the word communicate, right? Y'all know the definition. Y'all smart enough. But I'm going to give y'all some synonyms, synonyms that I think will make sense. So when I look at, when I was researching the word communicate for synonyms, one, you look at to spread or to carry or convey or pass on, right? But then I saw some more synonyms that I thought made more sense for where we're going today. And that was to meet up or to be in touch or keep in touch or to touch bases with. See, I like those a little bit more because that implies a continual communication. Now, why is that important? Because in this day and age, you know, I know those. We can just leave. I can tell you one or two times. You'll come to church with me next Sunday. Give your life to the Lord. Happily ever after. That sounds good 20 years ago. That ain't today. You're going to have maybe 17 conversations before they even pull up here. And then when they get here, it may be 11, 12 times before they say, I'm going to go ahead and accept the call. Then it may be 13, 14 more times before they say, I'm going to join the ministry. But are you ready to receive them? Are you ready to take them in and be patient with them? Amen. Now, I see my highway students wave your hand right quick. Let me see y'all. Can y'all please tell me, if you don't mind, what is the simple definition of holiness? Anybody? Living as the word says to live. Amen. I'm going to reiterate, as I always do, we do not babysit in highway. We reach, train, equip the future church, and the future is now. Amen. But yes, holiness is living as the word says to live. Now that sounds great, right? However, it doesn't really mean a whole lot if you don't know what the word says to live it. So we must know the word, amen? And so in holiness being communicated in this generation, there are two points I want to make today. Everyone first say knowledgeable. We must be a knowledgeable church, a knowledgeable believer. What do I mean by that? That means we're dealing with people that's going to come through our doors, all these different religions, ideologies. They coming through the door, and they using our word. They're using our Bible. And if we ain't careful, a lot of times they know more scripture than we do. They know more scripture than us. So in communicating holiness, we must be knowledgeable of his word. We got to know what he's talking about in his word. So when they have questions about the existence of God and the necessity of Christ and what's the purpose of the church, we should be able to answer those questions. Because these are questions that need answers to them in the world. And two, everyone say patience. Oh, this is a big one right here. Lord knows in highway, we exercise much patience with your child. Amen. Much patience. But patience is what's needed. Because like I said, they're going to come do it. They might have to come do here 10, 11 times before they get it. But are you willing to invite them those 10, 11 times, or after the second, third time you gave up on them? Or when they come through here because they don't look the way you think they ought to look, we turn them away. Let me also say this concerning those that are coming. Those that are coming, when they give their lives to the Lord here, they're going to be first-generation Christians. It ain't like us where most of our friends had at least some level of a church background. That ain't the case no more. You know, everyone, even an atheist, when I went to school, knew John 3:16. None of that is the case no more. They're not coming with any church background. Their only church background is Greenleaf. That's it. Which, for the record, why I don't watch TV shows that downplay the church. I don't support any show because all church ain't bad. Why we always got to show that side? But that's a different conversation for a different day. But they're coming. And are we ready to be patient with, are we willing to be patient with them? Amen? Are we willing to be patient with them? So let's first go to Daniel 12. Because I want us to really see the times we're in right now. Daniel 12, 4. And if you know anything about Minister Malik, when you get there, say, I got it. I heard Pastor say it. I heard a few more say it. I need a few more before I go. Yeah. Y'all got it? I'm talking about. Oh, in the comment section, y'all better say I got it too. I do be checking. So y'all better go, YouTube, Facebook, around the world. I need to see it in the comment section, all right? Praise God. Daniel 12:4. I am going to flip-flop, do some versions, but they'll be on the screen for you. Because I love y'all. I'm going to make y'all lives easier. And so the New King James Version reads, but you, Daniel, if you read this chapter, it's talking about the end times. The end game. We've seen the movie, the Marvel movie, right? The end game. And it says here, but you, Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book until the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall increase. Can everyone hold up this right quick? You got one of these smart devices. Not an Android, if you have an actual smart device. I'm having fun with y'all, man. Have some fun. I'm cool. Hey. Whoa, let me duck. Let me get out the way. I love you, Miss Lenny. You know I do. But everyone that has one of these, you have all knowledge right here. There's a song we learned when I was a baby, a little child in Eagle's Nest. He got the whole world in his hand. Shout out to those that, hopefully I'm a good product of y'all. But so we used to sing that song, but man, if you have one of these, you do kind of have the whole world in your hand. And maybe that explains why so many people think they're God now. Everything is researchable. Everything, as we say now, is Googleable. Everything. And if you go to YouTube, you'll swear everybody's a scholar. Everyone's a Bible, biblical scholar. If you ain't careful, they'll suck you right in. Which is why we must be knowledgeable. As the world is increasing in knowledge, we must increase in Bible knowledge and truth. Because the reality is, they're coming to us. Why? Because no matter how much truth you have, as long as you don't have the truth, questions will still be asked. Which means we that have the truth should be ready to answer. We must be knowledgeable. That's why, as it says in 2 Timothy 2:15, what does it say? To study, to show thyself, to prove unto God a workman that needed not to be ashamed, rightly dividing word of truth. Rightly, not wrongly. Amen? And here's something that I can say from personal life experience. To know God is to see the need for holiness. I know that was too deep, so I'm going to say it again. To know God is to see the need for holiness. See, the more I see all who God is and all he created me to be, the more I realize I need to get like him for real, for real. Because whatever I think I am, I'm nothing compared to what he created me to be. So again, to know God is to see the need holiness. With that, let's go to a familiar scripture, Leviticus 11:45. Y'all know this scripture. Y'all can quote it to me by heart. This is one of our former highway verses of the week that we do every Tuesday and Wednesday night. Leviticus 11:45. I'm going to read the New Century Version. When you get there, say, I got it. Yeah. I hear y'all. And it says here, I am the Lord who brought you out of Egypt to be your God. You must be holy because I am holy. Now, of course, we know that scripture. We even see it again in New Testament in 1 Peter. So, you know, beautiful scripture. And yes, we must be holy because he's holy. But let's focus on the first part of this verse. I am the Lord who brought you out of Egypt to be your God. Now, how many of y'all can say God has brought you out of something? Like he really brought you out of something. So really what this tells me is I need to be sharing this testimony to those that's going to be filling these seats. But in my testimony, it should be progressive, looking different. In other words, God brought me out of unemployment, but holiness brought me to promotion. God brought me out of homelessness and through homelessness and through holiness, I'm a homeowner. God brought me out of debt and brokenness, and through holiness, I'm now prosperous and operating in prosperity. See, that should be the result of him bringing us out, as it says in Leviticus. So that deliverance should be turning into holiness, which should be turning into favorable testimonies. We should be knowledgeable and keeping that before us when we do reach and talk to those that we know need to be here. Amen? It is imperative that we are doing what God needs us to do, so when we do talk to them, we're not 10 years in our faith, 20 years in our faith, saying, oh, the Lord bailed me out of jail last night, praise God. We still on that 20 years later. Like, we should be progressing. Because of holiness, you should be in jail ministering to them now. That's what it should be if we're called to be holy. Amen? Now, how many of y'all know God is love? Amen? We all know God is love. But love is patient. Love is kind. We can be so mean. We'll see a young queen come through here. She may have 5 kids, 6 kids. All of them got different last names. We'll side-eye her. But she needs love too. She needs patience as well. This is how holiness is communicated to this generation. See, I remember, you know, I shout out to my grandma, you know, and the grandmas I have here at the church, my praying grandmas. I love y'all. But you know, nowadays, grandmas, they my age. I'm not even 30 yet. They're my age. They ain't doing a whole lot of praying. Let me just say that right now. So this generation don't have those weapons interceding for them the way we did. So when they come through the door, they're coming through the door already with a bad misconception of church because of TV and the media, and really no real church experience. So are we willing to be patient with them? So again, in holiness being communicated, yes, one, we must be what? Knowledgeable. We got to know our stuff. And two, we must be patient, because God needs us to be patient. Amen. You got to be patient with these young folks. Look, I love our students in Highway, but every week don't be hitting like that. Sometimes they get on my nerves. They just do. But Lord knows they deserve the love and patience from us. Because look, shout out to y'all that was patient with your boy. Amen. Let's go to Colossians. Hey, some of y'all scream a little too loud when I said it. Chill out. But chill out. Let's go to Colossians chapter 3. Colossians 3 and 12. I'm going to read the New Century Version. When you get there, you know what to say. I hear you, Pastor Nims. I hear you. Y'all better be saying in the comment section, too. Colossians 3:12. And it says here, God has chosen you, say me, and made you, say me, his holy people. Ooh, that's a word right there. God has chosen you, breath of life, and made you, breath of life, his holy people. Amen. And I love how God loves. He loves to remind us how much he loves us. He says he loves you. He loves you. So what? You shall always clothe yourselves with what? Mercy, kindness, humility, gentleness. What's that last one? Patience. Because he loves us, he chose us, and he's made us his holy people. Patience, we gotta have. Because they coming, they gonna look any type of way. They may not look the way you think they ought to look, but they're on the way. Are we ready to receive them? When we get ready for our Helps Ministry initiatives, getting all of our young people plugged into as many auxiliaries as possible, you got to be patient with them. They may be in the audio room and they may say, get AA batteries. They come back with AAA. You got to be patient with them. They may pass the bucket wrong in ushers. You got to be patient with them. They may give you the wrong first aid kit with the Good Samaritans. Better be patient with them. Because that's what it's all about in communicating holiness to this generation. Amen. And let me give a shout out to Holy Spirit. How many of y'all, man, I love the Holy Spirit. Let me give a shout out. Because Holy Spirit helps communicate holiness. Holy Spirit helps communicate holiness. Why? Because when you're dealing with someone, Holy Spirit needs to be working in you, which means you better, first of all, be knowledgeable of Holy Spirit and how he speaks to you. And you better be patient to hear him. What the song say? I will wait on you, Lord. I will trust in you, Lord. Amen. Let's go to another familiar scripture. John 14:26. I'm going to read this in the ESV. Y'all receiving something so far? I heard, okay, there, I was waiting on it. There we go. Yeah, I wait on it. I got it. John 14:26. And it reads, but the helper, who the helper be? The Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, which of course we now have Holy Spirit. He will teach you what? All things. He's giving you what? Knowledge. Keeping you what? Knowledgeable. And bring to your remembrance all that I have said to you. He can't bring nothing to your remembrance that ain't there. Which means you must be studying to show yourself approved. I'm so glad we're at a ministry where we get the word 3 days a week, 4 times a week. And we even get it for your kids. So you should be feeding on his word constantly. Because when they come at you saying, why your God ain't God? Why your religion is the white man's religion, or all these other ideologies they're going to come up to you against. You better be knowledgeable of his word. You better know what the scriptures truly say, not what they're trying to make it say. Amen? Holy Spirit wants to be there for us to help us. That's his job. Amen? To be our helper. And in patience. How many of y'all, let me, before we get to our next verse, how many of you all have ever either been to a work training session or you had to be the one to administer the training session? You've either been the one or you had to be the one to do it. Were those training sessions like 2 minutes long and that was it, that was the day? No, right? It was probably lengthy, I would imagine. Probably annoying, probably rigorous. But guess what? That comes with training. And training takes a whole lot of what? Patience. With that, let's go to another familiar scripture, Proverbs 22:6. You can quote this one too, but I'm actually going to read this from two entirely different books of the versions of the Bible. So rock with me here. I want y'all to see something. As one conscious person say always, I want you to understand, overstand, and understand. Amen. Y'all there? Proverbs 22:6. I'm going to read the Common English Bible version, and then I'm going to read the what is known as the easy-to-read version, all right? And it says here, train who? Children. Or we can even go as far as spiritual babes. Train children in the way that they should go, and when they grow old or a level of maturity, right, they won't depart from it. But I love the word train because, again, that's not a one-day affair. That's not a one-time thing. You're constantly in training mode, like those synonyms for communicate, for communication, right? You're keeping base with them. You're touching bases with them. You're keeping in touch with them. Why? Because you got to have that continual communication going, especially if we're operating to give them holiness and communicating that to them. Amen. Now let's read the ERV. It says here, teach children. How many of y'all are teachers or former educators? See y'all, shout out to y'all. Thank God for y'all. Y'all had students for 180 days, and you still had to flunk some. Ain't that something? You had 180 days to get it. You still had to flunk some. But guess what? They need patience, too. Because they're coming through these doors, too. They're going to need you to love on them, too. Be long-suffering with them, too. Teach children in a way that what fits their needs. Woo! Teach children in a way that fits their needs. Because they're coming in with different types of needs. Especially our black people. They come in with some mental and psychological needs. And that's just the reality of it concerning us. They're coming with needs. And are we ready to answer those questions, be knowledgeable? And are we ready to be patient with them, long-suffering with them? Teach children in a way that fits their needs. They may need to just talk and you just listen. They may need you to tell them, but tell them in a different way. However, we got to get the job done. We got to get the job done. Teach children in a way that fits their needs. And even when they are old, they will not leave the right path. There's only one right path. And that's the highway of holiness. Amen. With that, can I tell y'all a story? Can I tell y'all a story? I'm going to tell y'all a true story. Maurice, I'm going to drink some of this holy water first. Like living water. So I'm going to tell y'all a true story. This happened probably 10 years ago. At this time, I was probably 19, 20 years old. At this time, I was working at Federal Express. Right? I was working at Fed. And at this time, I was still slanging boxes. You know, I'm one of these people everyone knew kind of, oh, man, you know, if you're going to talk to Malik, you're going to probably get scripture or two, or, you know, he probably usually got some decent advice for you. That was my reputation. And one guy in particular, I ain't going to disclose his name, so I'm going to give him a code name today. His name today will be Junebug, all right? Everyone knows a June or a Junebug, so we're going to go with that. Amen. Praise God. So me and this guy, Junebug, you know, we will always just have conversation. We gravitated towards each other, and, you know, it was just, you know, simple kind of, you know, guy talk, really, sports talk and just things of that nature we will always have conversations about. And every so often he'll come to me and he'll say, yo, man, Malik, you know, I ain't really on that God stuff, that Jesus stuff, church, that ain't really what I'm on, dog. That ain't me. And so I was like, man, I get it, man. I would love to kind of hear your concerns. And he would have those concerns. He'll ask those questions and about God and Jesus, you know, as a white man thing, and you know, there's all these other different questions he would have. And even at that time, I was pretty nerdy concerning scriptures and all of that, so I had a little information I can give him. So, one, I'm what? Knowledgeable. And so in the midst of this, we're talking months later, well over a year later, we're still, you know, building a rapport and, you know, building a relationship with him, with Junebug, and in the midst of that, he ended up calling me one day. Now, he called me while I was with my other friends. We were playing video games. And so we're playing the game and, you know, just kind of having a good time on the weekend, right? And he calls me. I could tell he was a little drunk. He was like probably 6, 7, 8 years older than me at the time. And so he called in a little, you know, drunk, just turned up, cursing, all over the place. Now, cursing wasn't a new thing to hear from him because he cursed all the time with me. Man, Malik, my MFN word, what's good, brother? Like, that was how he greeted me. So, so in the midst of that, you know, hey, do you? I ain't tripping like that. However, when you're in my atmosphere, there's a certain atmosphere I got to keep. See, the standard of holiness don't go nowhere. That includes my atmosphere, my space, when I'm with my people, right? And so I'm like, hey, man, look, I love you, man. You on speakerphone right now, so if you can dial it down on the cursing, I greatly appreciate that. And he was like, man, F all that, da 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 da. I said, man, look, I love you, but you keep going, I'm going to have to click on you. I'm going to have to just hang up this phone in love. And he kept going, he kept going, he kept going. Had to hang up on him. Had to. Couldn't take it. And that was that until the next work night, which was like, I think a day or two later. So we proceed, and a day or two later, I see him at work at night. He comes up to me, straight to me, and says, yo, Malik, man, I just want to say I'm sorry about the other day when I called you. I was a little drunk. I was a little crazy. Shouldn't have said all that. That's my bad, bro. Man, it's all good. Me being patient with him. It's all good. All love, right? And so he proceeds to tell me that his car broke down that day. And so he was like, look, man, someone brought me to work. Could you take me home from work? I said, yeah, no problem. No thing at all. I learned a valuable lesson that night. Because, again, I was 19, 20 years old. I learned a valuable lesson. When people say they live down the street from anywhere, they don't. They don't. Man, yeah, I'm right down the street from Fed. I don't care, bet. Like a fool. Whew. So, after work, 3-4 in the morning, we get in the car. Another disclaimer, another thing I should probably point out, he always had a smell on him for whatever reason. He just didn't understand why he just deep. And if you had Fed, the aroma just is what it is. And so, but you know, again, you got to be long-suffering. See, I've already shown him the knowledgeable part. And now I'm showing him the patience element. Because I want to communicate my God to him. I want to communicate what holiness looks like to him. Because he deserves that same long-suffering that was given to me. That was given to you. So we're driving home. I mean, driving to his house. 35 minutes later. And, we finally pull up at his driveway. In the midst of this, while we're driving there, Holy Spirit tells me, because again, he's my helper, he tells me to play certain songs. Let me give a shout out also to Christian hip hop music. That's why I'm an advocate for it. And so I'm playing certain songs in the car, songs that are really feeding the word to him. We ain't saying much because I'm tired. I'm trying to hold my breath. And obviously, he's tired. And so, it was cold outside, so I couldn't let the window down. So, it was just, got to take it. You know what I'm saying? Take it for the team. Take it for the team. But, he's worth it. Just like those that are coming are worth it. So, anywho, 35 minutes later, we pull up in his driveway. And he's like, yo, it's pouring out these questions about eternal life, Jesus, and all these different things about, like, why does he love me, and like, what I do to deserve all that. And I'm just, again, being knowledgeable, feeding it to him, giving it to him. 20 minutes later, sitting in his driveway, I lead him to the Lord. And so, move forward. That was, nearly 10 years ago. He's still doing well. I see Junebug from time to time on the social, and it's just a beautiful thing to see. But in the midst of that process, I had to be knowledgeable, and I had to show enough be patient. I had to be, because I want to communicate holiness to him. I want to communicate that, yo, the God that has blessed me with the privilege to live for him, he loves you too. He wants you too. He desires you too. And as we are moving forward with holiness, it is imperative that we understand how we must communicate holiness to this generation. Because it's not going to be the way you think it is. Oh, I'm just going to tell that child, and if they don't get it, oh, well, they're going to hell. Like, that can't be how we write them off. If you want to, sometimes they just get on your nerves. I get it. We had a child back there, didn't want to obey, took him to my office. He was like, I'm going to get my mama to press charges on you. Like, that, this is your mama telling you this stuff. So that you coming, you going home today. But that child deserves love too. That child deserves patience too, because I want to communicate holiness to that child. I want to communicate holiness to that young man who's going to come in here with makeup on, who don't know he a king. I want to communicate holiness to that young girl who got molested, to remind her that God loves her. To let her know, to put it before them, because as we know, faith coming by hearing. Hearing by the word of God. We have to be intentional in that, because they're on the way. Sooner than you think. Don't think we got time. If this pandemic showed us anything, we ain't got much of that. We ain't got much time. They on the way. And they're coming unchurched. They're coming with no background of church. All they know is what TV then told them. So not only they have no background, they coming already thinking negative. But that church, why that church so big? I bet pastor got all the tithes and offerings. This is the concept that they coming with before they come here. They wrote off everybody in this thing. And we got to love on them. We got to be patient with them. We gotta, and then when they do finally say, I'm here, I'm all in, we gotta then train them. And as we know, training is not easy. Training ain't always fun. There's some steps you wish you can skip. But it ain't like that. We must be intentional in communicating holiness to this generation. Because again, we're not changing the message. The standard is still there. None of that goes away. What the standard that was built 40 years ago, it still stands today. Just how we express it is different, that's all. And expression ain't, that ain't bad. God did it all the time. He does it all the time. So again, we don't change the message of holiness, just how we express holiness. That's how we must communicate holiness to this generation. Because they deserve it. Why? Because Jesus says so. Why these young people deserve it? Because Jesus says so. If it was up to Malik, praise God. But they deserve it. So church, are we ready to receive them? Are we ready to receive the future? Because the future is now. Holiness communicated. Amen. Bow your heads with me. Bow your heads with me. Father God, we just thank you and we praise you, Lord, for your word. We thank you and we praise you for revelation, Father God. We thank you and we praise you, Father God, that we are a church that is ready to receive your people as we move forward with the vision of holiness. Father God, we are a church that loves. We are a church that is patient. We are a knowledgeable church, Father. We know your word, and we will continue to study your word, Father. And Lord, we thank you and we praise you for the overflow that is to come. We thank you and we praise you for those that are on their way. We even thank you and praise you for those that have left that are coming back. We thank you and we praise you, Father God. Hallelujah to your wonderful name. In Jesus' name we pray. Keep your heads bowed. I take nothing for granted. We're going to be patient even with this. God, I've been telling you about with all this patience, that God loves you in your seats and those watching around the world. How much God loves you? He sent his son Jesus to die just for you. If you're the only person on planet Earth, he would have did it just for you. How much he loves you. He knew you would be here today to hear this good news, to hear this invitation. So I pray that you accept the call. As the word says, the day you hear his voice, harden not your heart. So if you know in your seat or watching, you have never given your life to Jesus Christ, but you most certainly would like to do that. First, I want to make sure I give the sanctuary an opportunity to do it before I pray. So if that is you in the sanctuary today, you know you need to accept the call and receive Jesus as your Lord and Savior. If that is you, please stand. And for those that are watching online, we'll be briefly, we'll be going over a prayer. But I want to reiterate that Jesus loves you. And it's so easy to receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior. It's not, you know, I know we just discussed training and everything, but this, one of them things is actually very easy. Matter of fact, it's literally as easy as ABC. A, admit that you are a sinner. B, believe that Jesus paid for your sin on the cross. And C, confess that Jesus Christ is Lord and commit your life to him. So again, if you have never received Jesus as your Lord, but you want to do that today, please just raise your hand now. Don't be ashamed. And for those watching online that want to give your life to the Lord, just simply now repeat after me. Say, Father God, I admit I am a sinner. I come to you asking for forgiveness for my sins. I believe in my heart that Jesus is your son and that he died on the cross for me. And I believe you raised him from the dead. I confess now with my mouth that Jesus Christ is Lord. And I invite you into my life. And now I am cleansed and made new by the blood of Jesus. Thank you for saving me. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. If you said that prayer for the first time and you meant it, you are now saved. Praise God. Here's a video with more information concerning what you just received in salvation.
Congratulations. If you just prayed and accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you are walking in new life. You are now a child of God, and it's time to develop a solid foundation. No need to wonder what to do next. Dr. Holloway has authored a short book entitled Welcome to the Kingdom. This powerful, easy-to-read book guides you through your next steps for growing in the kingdom of God. As our gift to you, we would like to send it to you free of charge. To claim your gift, simply write us a request at P.O. Box 281-394, Memphis, Tennessee 38168, or call our pastoral support at 901-383-5551. We rejoice with you, just as the angels of God rejoice over one sinner who repents. Welcome to the kingdom.
Praise God, praise God. I pray you receive that information, and we look forward to having you a part of the ministry. And again, welcome to the kingdom of God. Amen? Amen, praise God. Am I doing time enough? Are you? Oh, Anthony, okay, praise God. Well, I pray y'all receive something today. I pray you receive something today. Again, in holiness communicated, let's be knowledgeable and let's be patient as we are reaching this generation with holiness. Amen. Praise the Lord. And now I'm going to give it to the man himself, Minister Anthony Williams.
I love you, Jesus. I worship and adore you. Just want to tell you that I love you more than anything. Amen, amen. Did you hear God's love up here today? Amen, amen. I'm telling you, man, that was a good word, Minister Malik. Minister Malik, that was a good word. For those who don't know, I am Anthony Williams, A-Dub. That's what they call me around here at the church. And I am here to help you advance your future. So everybody say, level up. Level up. Amen, amen. That's what Holiness 2.0 is about, leveling up. But I want to kind of give you some encouragement and motivation in doing so. You know, the Lord has been actually directing me back to, you know, certain scriptures. And, you know, sometimes we read scriptures and kind of take it for granted, or we may let it slip. But every time you go back to that scripture, God will give you something new and refreshing if you go with your expectors on. Amen? Amen. Today I was at, and I'm going to tell you, I know I'm moving in the right direction because of the message, because of praise and worship. He gave me John 3:16. And everything that we talked about today was all about the love of God. Being patient with those who come through those doors, be willing to make sacrifices and so. But as I was going through, you know, just looking up the scripture, John 3:16, which I'm quite sure all of you can quote it, one of the things that came to mind was value. Value. I just went to the dictionary and I looked it up, and it has, you know, it has some meanings, but in the noun, it says here, it says the regard that something is held to deserve the importance, worth, or usefulness. Something. I mean, I couldn't, I couldn't really get past deserve. I broke down. Now we're talking about John 3:16. I mean, I just broke down. And as I go on, it says the importance, worth, or usefulness. I just broke down. Talking about John 3:16. Now, as a verb, it states here, iPhone, let me give you some play. So here it is. It says, consider someone or something to be important or beneficial, have a high opinion of. When I read John 3:16, God put value that he was willing to give up not only one of his sons, but his only begotten son. It says, for God, so, I ain't gonna mess this one up. Let's stick with it. Let's stick with scripture. Here, you know, We sung that, we just got up here in praise and worship, and we talked about, we was talking to God how, because everybody participated in praise and worship, right? Right, we was up here, everybody in the church was singing about how much we love you, God. Just want to tell you that I love you more than anything. Now, I'm going to show you how God, you know that God heard you by what you do next. See, based off scriptures, this is what it says, and it says here, the way God loved the world, the way that God loved the world, he gave his only unique son as a gift. So now everyone who believes in him will never perish, but experience everlasting life. Man, when I looked at that scripture, I put my name there because he valued me. Even when I didn't deserve it, he valued me. So he says, so I say, for here is the way God loved. He gave not only his one of his sons, but his only unique son as a gift for Anthony. So now, Anthony, when he believes in me, he won't perish, but he will experience everlasting life. Not when I die, but while I'm in the earth too. Amen? But now look at this. Now, God gave us proof based on scripture how he loved us, how he valued us. Now, it's time for us to allow our audio to match our video. Amen? So we just got through talking about God, I love you. I just want to tell you that I love you more than anything. If you value God and the work that he's doing here at the ministry, at Breath of Life, support it. And he'll know how much you love him by the sacrifice that you're willing to make for him. Amen? Amen. Let's pray. Father, we just thank you for giving your one and only begotten son for us, which was an example to us of your love, of your sacrifice, and how you value us. We thank you and praise you for that example, Lord. And because we have that example, we can imitate you in doing the same. As this year progresses, Father, we commit to level up, to make more sacrifices, to be more committed, to be more faithful, and to be able to give even the more to the good work here in the ministry, Lord. And we just thank you and praise you right now because we give, Father God. We're believing, Father God, that you're raising up men and women to give into us good measure, pressed down, shaking together and running over. We just thank you and praise you right now for this opportunity. Amen and thank God. Amen, amen. Now, on the screens, as you see, those who are watching and those in here, we have four ways to give. All you have to do if you want to partake of giving at this time, could actually move forward with doing so with one of those options. Amen? Amen. Let's value God, look at brothers and sisters. So let's continue to make the necessary sacrifices and be the example that we need for to be the example to the world that God needs for us to be. Amen? Amen. Now, if you would, turn your attention to the bill.
Morning, and welcome to Bell News. 2021 contribution statements are available upon request. To request your statement, please call 901-383-5555 or visit bolcc.org and select Give. Your contribution statement can be mailed, emailed, or picked up. If you would like to pick up your statement, you may do so during office hours, Tuesday through Friday, from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. The audiovisual department is in the process of training board operators, lighting engineers, streaming techs, and camera operators. If interested, please see Sharon Gray or call 901-679-7666. Join us this Wednesday, January 26th, for our virtual Vision Day celebration. The College and Career Ministry will lead our Vision Day 2022 virtual service. If you are attending via Zoom, please visit bolcc.org for the Zoom link. If you will be attending via Facebook, our Facebook page is at BOLCC Memphis. Be sure to invite someone, and again, tune in at 7 p.m. sharp. And get ready. On Sunday, January 30th, our Vision celebration continues with part two. You do not want to miss this in-person worship celebration.
we have a special treat for you, a panel that features our legacy pastors and Holiness 2.0. So be sure to invite someone and join us for in-person worship on Sunday, January 30th. See you then. This concludes Bell News. We'll see you here or on Zoom this Wednesday at 7 p.m. sharp. Thank you for joining us and have a blessed week.
Amen, amen. Now we are acknowledging those who may be celebrating a birthday or an anniversary today or one day this week. If you would, please stand. All right. Oh, Lord Jesus. Don't stone her, y'all. Don't stone her. Amen, amen. Anybody else? Anybody else? Okay, I see you, Miss Montgomery. I see you back there. Amen, amen. Who is there back there? Oh, okay. I see you, Miss Hazel. Well, on behalf of Dr. Holloway and First Lady Addie, First Lady Holloway and all the, who else? Oh, I see you, Sam. I see you. On behalf of Dr. Holloway and First Lady Holloway and all the Breath of Life family, we want to wish you guys the best birthday that you ever had. We believe and trust that this week, or whatever day it may be, that the Lord will grant you your heart's desire. Amen? Amen. Thank you. All right. All right. All right. At this time, this concludes our service today. And before we leave, I just want to confess a blessing over you guys. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace throughout the week. Thank you all for attending. Amen.